They're a death squad, Mike. They've got orders to shoot me on sight.
What could have happened?
I will find out.
Heals over in minutes. Most people don't even know they've been infected.
What did you do with his body?
They can regenerate. We just don't know how.
He was on the take.
No, you are lying.
Do you know where your loved ones are going to be in 50 years' time? Battery farms. Believe me, our free-range days are over.
Anyway, they wanted to know if Wilson had spoken to the board. Waldo told me weeks ago. Nothing was said officially, but Waldo knew. We pulled out of Stirling by 3 o'clock that afternoon. We would have lost the best part of a million. Tokyo were furious.
I'm sorry, we lost track of time. Have you had her up all night? What's your name? Ashford. Danny Ashford. I pay the bills.
Oh.
Hello, stranger.
Waldo has to take.
You're worn out, aren't you, Max?
I'll do that. I'd like to say goodbye to her alone, please, if that's okay.
He has to raise his stakes to keep his life interesting. And I think he ought to do something about his hair. I don't mean a wig, but just let a bit more grey in. Unless, of course, he wants to be a recluse. And I think that would be a very great loss. Oh, it was the mirror. That's who it was. Not the Times.
Bye. I didn't think you'd wait.
You don't get rid of me that easily. It's no rush. Did she answer your question?
I think so. Sorry, I'm letting you down. Letting myself down.
It's all right. You've got to be sure I can respect that. It's not as if you can get your money back. You keep asking. As long as you like.
Do you dream?
I don't remember.
I'm ready.
Good.
So why hasn't anyone tried taking one of them alive? All right, dead then. Undead, whatever you call it.
They don't take prisoners.
Well, so we're no better?
No, they're better. Stronger, faster. Surprise is about the only thing we've got going for us, so forget about a fair warning.
It's okay, don't worry, I'm all right.
Get out!
you don't like the idea, then keep away from her. She's had contact.
Yeah, and he's been put away, so what's the issue?
They know about her, they know about you, and they want to know about us. Now just think if the leeches got hold of her, sucked her empty. That wouldn't be the end of it. They'd use her to get at you, and then us.
So no friends, then?
You've got me.
What, none of you have got any friends?
I've got friends. You want to meet them? Most of my mates I met in the service. Still dropping to see them now and again.
Why were they taken?
Angie reckons leeches knew about the Gulf War syndrome way before we did. They're obsessed with viruses, diseases, anything that messes up their food supply.
How can it infect them? It's not the whole point.
It can't kill them. But it must hurt. Otherwise, they wouldn't be putting so much time and energy into it. The point is, when they were taken, I had to neutralize them.
Yeah. Friendly fire.
Yeah. You know what it's like. And if you don't want to do it again, I'd let her go.
I rang your station, Michael. Spoke to the super. When were you going to tell me?
Do you want to sit down?
He said you resigned for personal reasons. Because of Jack.
No, it just felt like a change.
Oh, a transfer I could understand, but you've quit after 10 years. It's not worth it. Not letting him ruin my life.
It's just a job.
And, what about me? Is it all change?
What?
Do you blame me? Do you think I led him astray by asking for things that he couldn't afford?
God, no.
I don't know what you expect me to think. I thought we had more in common than just Jack.
Sorry. What is it?
We've got a job.
Yeah, can't I meet you there?
No, we go together.
Just give us 10 minutes.
What for?
Kirsty, this is Mr. Rice.
Yeah. You were at the wedding asking questions about Jack.
Yes, sir, that's not wrapped up yet.
I've tried to get hold of you lot. No one returns my calls. Do you know where Jack is?
Sorry. Can't talk about that.
But you can talk to him. I'll leave you to it then.
What could I do? She just turned up.
Look, don't try and make her feel better. You'll make it worse.
Some of him. Whatever's left can't be too pretty.
Are we sure it survived?
It's a partial elimination. If the whole thing had gone up, there wouldn't be a car left.
Driving around in broad daylight. You've got to admire their nerve. Who's the owner?
It's registered to Lester Hammond, as in Gideon Hammond. His son. I haven't got all the details yet, but for a rich kid, he's been very shy the last few years, of daylight, certainly. And no recent photos, despite the paparazzi.
Neil, so you're sure no one else is in this car?
I don't know. I didn't get a good look before it caught fire.
Yeah, there's some...
I've told your boss, I'm telling you. His face caught fire. Okay? Don't ask me again. Look, no. The sun was behind me. It come from the car.
That's what I mean. A reflection.
Oi! I've already had a breathalyzer, all right?
Are you sure? They looked like they were going to arrest him.
No, they won't. He's not doing himself any favours. Look, no one wants any more trouble for you two. I can sort this out. You've just got to get him to keep quiet. We'll find out who did this.
Yeah. And he'll probably just get off with a fine.
I don't think so.
He motors down and you come after us. What is he, an MP? I got the licence plate. You should have his name by now.
That number doesn't check out. You must have got that wrong too.
I saw where he was driving. I know how it works. I saw it never do time.
He will. But if your bloke keeps mouthing off about this fire, he's going to get stepped on. Can you talk to him?
He won't listen to me. And why should I listen to you? Whatever he says, it's the truth. Don't you judge him, because it's not his fault.
Hey, come here, come here, hey, come here.
This investigation is about money. Where it comes from, where it goes. You've seen their involvement in counterfeiting. Much just a sideline. This man is worth millions, or rather his father is. Gideon Hammond.
So why didn't they recruit him?
He's a public figure. You've seen what happens when they go out in the daylight.
Besides, they have more subtle ways of manipulating their targets. They often use children.
Where does he live?
Under surveillance. But neutralizing him is not our first priority.
So it's not all seek and destroy, then?
We want answers as much as you do. Follow the money.
Three years is a long time without even a phone call. What happened?
His mother died. I stopped bailing him out.
You never got on?
Worst investment I ever made. Comes a time when you have to stop throwing good money after bad. Cut your losses.
Who supports him now? That was a customised Jaguar he was driving.
Persuading people to give him money has never been Lester's problem. He'd use my name when it suited him. Every few months I'd be approached by one of his creditors. He'd have done very well in the city.
You talk of him in the past tense.
Do I? How very telling.
So he has no involvement in your companies whatsoever?
No, none. You know, when you arrived, I thought you were going to tell me that he'd been washed up on a beach somewhere. That's terrible, isn't it? I suppose I shall have to organise his defence when you do finally catch up with him. How is the young lady?
Difficult to say with spinal injuries. I doubt she'll walk again unaided.
I'll see that she's taken care of. You've no need to worry. You'll get no sanctuary here.
Has Angie got kids?
One. I left her with one.
Danny Ashford, Detective Sergeant Vaughn Rice, Detective Constable Michael Colefield.
Hit and run, you said?
No, we're treating this as an attempted murder.
Murder?
Yeah, a girl was crippled by your client's car.
Ex-client. Lester's account was closed 3 years ago.
Why was that?
He wouldn't take advice. Dealt directly with his brokers until his father stopped picking up the tab.
And you still deal with his dad's money, is that right? What's he into?
Futures. Mostly government bonds. Look, I thought this was about a hit and run.
Is there any way Lester could get at his dad's money?
Apart from armed robbery? No.
How do futures work?
It's a little complicated. How long have you got?
Well, it's like being at a racetrack. They stand around in pits waving and shouting at each other, right?
Yeah. The transactions are done by open outcry.
What, face to face? Not on the screen?
Face to face.
Where?
Life. London International Futures Exchange. You won't get on the floor. Security's very tight.
What do you mean, everything?
I mean, liquidate all the positions. Immediately. I'm closing my account.
It's what you call invisible earnings. Esther gets on the floor without showing up on video. There are no windows, and he puts the bite on whatever broker he's dealing with. Gets any deal he wants. Makes a killing, but on his dad's account, which makes your guy a liar. They're in this together. No question.
He doesn't strike me as a doting father, and I've had a conversation with him in broad daylight. No signs of infection. And by the way, looks like there may have been someone else in the car.
So how do we know it's not Lester's?
Leeches don't use phones.
How come?
Look, the only machine that can see or hear a leech is us. You can only see them face to face. No mirrors, no photos, no videos. Audio's the same. He can make a call, but his voice won't go down the line. The surveillance is a bitch.
But I don't see how selling up is going to throw them off. I don't want to lead them to you.
I'll contact you once you've done the executions.
Are you sure you want me to cancel all the stops?
Stay calm. I can take the pain.
Gideon started selling almost as soon as we turned up. Right, he's going, I'll have cashed in everything by tomorrow.
Where's he putting it?
Cash. Certificates of deposit. It's the next best thing, you can offload them anyway.
His bank is coordinating this?
Yeah, Danny Ashford. She wants to hand it over to Gideon in person. He won't explain why he's closing the account. They can visit it.
And the handover is where? Gideon's?
Yep, and we'll be there to pick up Junior. How much do you think Danny knows? Do you think she knows what he is?
What does she care? His money's good. She's a banker, he's a leech, they're probably related.
Shouldn't we pull her in?
What, and scare her off?
Wasn't there somewhere finding out she's infected? No, bring her for questioning, stick her under UV.
No, it doesn't prove anything. Listen, not everyone that works for them is infected. People play along for all sorts of reasons. They have a way of finding out what you want. Or who.
I thought you'd try this.
Not with partial remains.
And?
So far it's completely inert. Just like the others. Maybe blood isn't the key.
The boys have made progress. In the outside world.
Gideon's into property. Specialised architectural requirements, basements, no plumbing, no heating, tinted windows. I spent the best part of the day with his financial director. I promise, I just got here.
So?
I'm not neglecting the day job.
He's building safe houses. It doesn't really expand our picture.
There are one or two offshore companies I've been following up. They may show up something.
You want me out of your hair?
This is where you'll beat them in the end, you know.
So long as you don't get tunnel vision. Now, I know how this research goes. You work in a timescale of years. And we may not have that long.
Should have called. Look, I know I've been a bit off.
No argument there. How's the new job?
How much do you know about that?
Only that you're tucked away in T Branch somewhere. So Jack was involved in terrorism then?
Believe it or not. Look, I'm not going to screw up your evening.
You won't. You can have a drink, tell me what you want, and then I'm throwing you out.
Thanks.
Aren't you a bit old for one of those? Anyone I know?
No.
So what can I do for you this time? Well, what's up?
I wanted to ask you about the kind of work you do. How you stop it from getting in the way.
Of what?
Everything. Your life.
My post isn't that sensitive. What are they saying to you?
I'm supposed to stay away from people that I care about.
Your people don't know about me, do they?
Mm-mm. People who knew Jack.
They've warned you off Kirsty. Well, look, they're not saying you have to be a hermit. Just choose your friends carefully. You know that from being a policeman. You don't go out clubbing with villains or their girlfriends.
None of this is her fault.
You should quit. Go back to your old job.
Yeah. It's about time you threw me out, isn't it?
Look, there are plenty of people that can do your job, Mike. They don't need you. If you've got any doubts, you should get out now before they get their claws in and then you lose the choice.
Yeah, well, thanks for the advice.
I just don't think you're cut out for it. You're too straight. It's a compliment.
I know.
Small print, Danny. Shares can go down as well as up. If you play the market, you can get burnt.
Are you in pain?
I'll live. How long will it take to settle the differences?
The certificate should be there by close of play tomorrow. So will those investigators, I'm sure of it.
Let them.
They know about you.
We know about them. They're old friends, nothing to be frightened of. Michael's one of us. He just doesn't know it yet.
Did you hear me? They know all about you.
They don't know a damn thing. And neither will you till you get off the fence. Try a little faith. Don't you trust me anymore? Just bring the money.
What about them?
Hey,
There's no law against it. What am I talking about? You're not a copper anymore, are you? I don't have to explain myself.
What are you doing?
What are you doing? Looks to me like you're off to work. Where's that then? I don't like being lied to. I'm sick of being lied to. Are you working for the people that investigated Jack?
Yes.
Fine. And did you turn him in? Is that why they took you on?
No.
Good. Good. That didn't kill you, did it? Are there still things that you're not telling me about Jack? I mean, I know that there are. Do you think there are things that I don't want to know?
There's nothing else.
Liar. Stop protecting me, will you? I love you for it, but don't.
Look, why don't we meet up tomorrow?
Only if you've got something to tell me.
These don't match. The biker said he had blue eyes. These are definitely brown.
Look. Well, everything else matches. Or you think he had a twin brother we didn't know about?
I don't know.
Well, look, the last thing you do is look into their eyes. If you want to be sure, use video. He'll be the one of half a face missing. Shouldn't be too difficult to spot. He won't even look human. You frightened of making a mistake?
Of course not. No hesitating, shoot first, no warnings. Why worry? Something on her hand.
I don't know what that is, but it's not a bite.
That's a burn.
And on the basis of that, you decided she was with Lester in the car?
The biker saw no one, remember?
What kind of prints did he get off the car?
Fire didn't leave any. What else have you got?
The log off her mobile. She called an old people's home night before the accident.
A mother, we know, so what?
Well, it's on the same motorway the car came in on. That's her mobile you found under the passenger seat.
Even if you're right and she was with Lester, I don't see how that affects tonight.
She's a decoy. She knows she's under surveillance, so does he. He's not going to turn up, they're just stringing us along.
Your suggestion?
Bring her in for questioning.
And the stakeout?
Call it off.
Bullshit.
It's a waste of time.
Tonight goes ahead. If there's no show, we pick her up afterwards. Agreed?
Oh, great. So in the meantime, they're getting on with whatever it is we're supposed to be investigating. I know the man said follow the money. Let's just show a bit of initiative.
I don't know where he is. He'd kill me if he saw me talking to you.
Did he talk to you about what he saw?
Can't you just leave us alone?
He said that the face that he saw had blue eyes. He only saw it for a split second. How can he be sure?
Because they were all blue. He said that when the sun hit him, it just went totally blue.
This had better be good. First time ever.
But the payments come every month.
On the dot. As if that was the important thing.
Why do you think she came that night?
Conscience finally caught up with her? Or maybe a boyfriend persuaded her?
And he waited in the car?
Waited all night.
May we see her?
Orchestra, a small chamber orchestra outside her bedroom.
What did she used to do?
Her birthday.
I think she did something in the city. She worked for some bank or other.
Especially.
Did she keep any of her personal stuff in?
Don't you need a warrant for that?
You know, is the best I'll ever
her daughter's in a lot of trouble.
Half the hall were in tears.
It's from a Waldemar Hammerfett, 1952. They were close. I wonder if he's still around.
Yes, he is. But he's not calling himself Waldo anymore.
Lester?
Lester's grandfather. It's Gideon's father we're after, not his son.
She handled Waldemar's finances and her daughter took over.
Danny must have known him all her life. Never aged. Unlike Mum. Is Alzheimer's hereditary?
It depends. There are two genetic markers. The risk goes up 30-fold if you have both.
Could Danny have got herself scanned?
Doesn't mean much. About 1 in 20 of us have both genes. You look far enough into the future, you're bound to see something you don't like. People forget. We're all programmed to die. Margaret Ashford opened the account, then her daughter Danny dealt with her.
We're talking 50-odd years ago.
Oh, Mr. Hammerfetz, of course. He's one of our oldest customers. In fact, I mean that quite literally. He never comes into the office. I believe he's over 90.
If you've never seen him, how do you know?
Oh, Miss Ashford does all the dealings with him.
Like a mother.
Well, he's been with us since the war.
What does he invest in?
A charity. All his money goes to charity. Often happens as you get older.
Which ones?
Medical. AIDS, leukemia, all kinds of disorders.
Blood disorders?
Oh, you must have heard of the Beacon Institute.
Were you ever afraid of him?
I was an obedient child. He had no cause to chastise me.
Where is he?
We know what we're dealing with. Don't touch anyone.
Can I get them some water?
No. This was a hospice. They thought they were on the latest drug trials. Prepared to put up with pretty much anything.
What kind of experiments would they do?
They've all been exposed to radiation, way above clinical dosage. If their immune systems weren't wrecked before, they are now.
I told the insurance. Give them the license number. And they got the address.
What were you thinking of doing? Hey!
You lot weren't doing anything. Didn't know you was gonna shoot him. What about me?
You'd better have good lawyers.
The best. You've been redecorating. Valdemar Hamovets, Gideon Sr. Born 1909, died 1943, age 34. Only he didn't die and he's still 34. I can't get enough of these. Drives them crazy, all that eternal youth and no mirrors. What happened to your own son? I can't believe he was that much of a disappointment to you. Is he dead?
Natural causes. He took an overdose 3 years ago. He's buried in the grounds.
Father just took over. A convenient way to re-enter society. How long has he been running your life?
Always.
Did you never want to be your own man?
Oh, easy to say. He was always stronger, he was always more experienced. There were a few years when we were in our prime together. For me, it passed. He promised he'd take me one day.
You were too useful where you were. Couldn't you see he was letting you die?
Your mother had an affair with him.
She took care of his investments and then he moved on to you. Have you got a thing about him as well? Because of the way you protect him otherwise, I mean, it's not like he's family or anything. Maybe he feels like family. He's been around so long. Is that what you want? Were you terrified you'd end up like your mother? Because it seems to me she wasn't good enough for him.
I only take those who want to go.
That is a lie.
He begged my mother to go with him. She refused.
And you think she made the wrong decision?
Well, you'd have to ask her that.
My 5-year-old daughter didn't choose to go. They don't just recruit, they kill.
You're the ones running the extermination program. You're like Nazis. Just because they're different. They're entitled to fight back. It's war.
She fits the profile. Mid-30s are the prime recruiting ground. It's when we first realise it's all going to end, however hard we hit the gym. How's she doing?
She is unlikely to crack early, and I'm not sure how much she knows. I'm not convinced she knew she was a decoy. As for the experiment,
I think we can make an educated guess there. I hope none of us thinks this interest in blood disorders is down to philanthropy. What they're researching is pollution, contamination of their food supply.
Yeah, well, good. Maybe they'll find a cure. Because you've got some common interests.
About as common as humans and cattle. What did we do when we discovered BSE was a threat? Did we go looking for a vaccine? No, we went for the most direct, short-term solution.
A cull.
They've done it before. The Fire of London. Or do you really think that was a happy coincidence in the middle of a plague?
You fancy a drink? On your first case.
You get away, what's to celebrate?
Well, we cost them a lot of money. And Angie's having orgasms with those bits and pieces we picked up.
Right, so what about the girl he mowed down? She spends the rest of her life in a wheelchair, he gets away scot-free.
I wouldn't say that. He's not a pretty boy anymore. He's got to live with that forever. And don't forget, anaesthetic doesn't work on him, so he's in permanent agony. I call that a result.
Let me show you how it feels.
Right, so you say they haven't got any feelings. Well, if that's not a grudge, I don't know what is. Why all the secrecy? Why not just go public, let people protect themselves?
Listen. Every week there's a panic about some puny little bug. Now, how do you think it would be if this got out? You'll have paranoia, you'll have vigilantes, you'll have people running back to religion in droves. The next thing you know, you'll have the Archbishop up for Prime Minister. I don't fancy living in Iran, do you?
Who's going to tell his girlfriend?
Not you! You leave that to the police.
Listen, mate, when your life has been shattered, it does help if you can make some sense out of it.
We're talking about his girlfriend or yours.
You really don't give a shit, do you? Look, we've got things to talk about. What are you doing tomorrow? How about before work? I can meet you there.
Great. I'm not going to hurt you. Look at me. I'm better. He put me right. Would you rather I was a cripple? Look, he didn't make me. No one can make you do anything you don't want to do. No one can make you change sides. But you're on the wrong side. These people that you're with, and you think we're evil. Can I tell you a few things about your friend?
Time to move.
Where to?
I'm not sure yet.
You mean you're not going to tell me?
Well, I just think we should take a break from each other, that's all.
Why?
Well, you're not going to get over Jack if you're mooning around me all the time.
What?
No, I'm thinking of you, someone has to.
Mike, what happened to Jack? He's dead, isn't he?
Look, why can't you just accept this? He was a shit and he shafted you.
You don't have to do this. We can help each other.
I can't be responsible for you. I've got my own life and I haven't got the time. Just move on. And we all make mistakes. Next time, just pick a bit more carefully.